स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास फिफ्थ, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ SRPS. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न चैप्टर 3 पार्ट 1, दैट इज मोर अबाउट वर्ड 2010, सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर. लेट्स स्टार्ट. वी विल लर्न सम फीचर्स ऑफ वर्ड दैट कैन चेंज द लुक ऑफ अ पेज. लेट्स सी. Page orientation. The orientation of a page is the direction in which it is displayed or printed. There are two types of page orientation: portrait and landscape. Now, what are portrait? What is landscape? Let's see. Portrait. In portrait, the height of the page is longer than the width. Once again, in portrait, the height of the page is longer than the width, as you can see in this picture. Landscape. In landscape, the width of the page is longer than the height. You can see in this picture, width is more than its height. Let's move ahead. To change the page orientation, what you need to do? You need to perform some steps. Three steps are there. First one, click on page layout tab. Step 2, click on page orientation in the page setup group. Step 3, select the required type of orientation. Now what you need to do? First step, click on page layout tab. Second, click on orientation tab, orientation option, and third, you need to choose portrait or landscape, whichever option you want. Fine. Let's move ahead. Page size. We can change the page size of a Word document using the size option. Now, student, listen, what is page size? You use your notebook, register or diary to note down your work. Sometimes you use diary, sometimes you use your notebook, or sometimes you use register. The size of the page is different in diary, in notebook, and in register. So these are the different type of pages. In the same way, in computer, in MS Word, there are different sizes of pages are there. We can choose before writing in it, or we can change the size of page after it. So A2, A3, A4, different type of pages are there. To change the page size, we need to follow some steps. So some steps are, first step, click on page layout tab. Step 2, click on size option in the page setup group. Step 3, select the required size from the available option. Three simple steps are there. First, click on page layout tab. Second, click on size option. And third, you need to choose the which size of page you want. Okay, let's move ahead. Page margin. Page margin is the blank space around the text on a printed page. Once again, page margin is the blank space around the text on a printed page. When you print a page on a paper, you can see surrounding of that printed page, white space is there, blank space is there. That blank space or white space is called margin. There are four margins on a page: top, bottom, left, and right. To set page margin in a document, what we need to do? We need to follow three steps. First, click on page layout tab. Second, click on margins option in the page setup group. Third, select the required option. These options are normal, narrow, moderate, wide, or mirrored. So any of these options any one of these options you can choose. Okay, to select the page margin, let's move ahead. Header and footer. What are header and what are footer? Let's see. Header is the top margin section of each page of a document. Footer is the bottom margin section of each page of a document. Header and footer display information such as title of the document, page number, author's name, etc. Students, suppose there is a book of 1000 pages which we have written in which we have typed in MS Word. After typing that book of 1000 pages, we want that on every page the name of the book would be printed, but we have not typed on every page. Means 1000 pages of book is there. We want that on every page name of the book would be printed. So what we need to do, we need to type the name of book on every page. So we have to type the name of book 1000 times. No need to do these things. MS Word gives us a very special and very good feature, that header and footer. You need to type the name of the book either in header or footer once, and you will see the name of that book will appear in all 1000 pages automatically. This is the specialty of header and footer. Let's see how we can insert header and footer. To insert header or footer in a document, step 1, click on insert tab. Step 2, from the header and footer group, click on header or footer, a gallery appears. Step 3, click a header style or footer style. Now types of text you want at the top or bottom of each page respectively. Students, just try to understand what we need to do. First step, click on insert tab. Second, click on header or footer. Now some option will be there. You need to choose option where you want to type, at the right side, at the left side, or at the middle. Where you want to type, you need to select that area and type your text. Step 4, click on close header and footer option from the close group in the design tab. After completing your task, you need to close that header and footer option, or you can double click in the document area to come out from header and footer option. Fine. If you want to remove header or footer option, what you need to do? Very simple steps are there. You need to click on insert tab, click on header option, and you will see an option that is remove header. Click on remove header option. If you want to remove footer, what you need to do? Click on insert tab, click on footer, and click on remove footer. So students, these are the topics which we have covered in chapter 3 part 1. Some more topics are there which we will cover in our next video, that is chapter 3 part 2. Okay, I hope you have understood all these topics. If you have computer with you, you can practice at your home. See this video again and again and do practice. Thank you very much.